या ओके
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वी आर बैक विथ अनदर इम्पेयर्ड सेल्स फोर्स सेशन. टुडे वी हैव दिव्या अग्रवाल मैम विथ अस एंड द सेशन इज ऑन हाउ टू एस ए सेल्स फोर्स इंटर इंट्रोडक्शन टू नॉन प्रॉफिट क्लाउड. दिव्या अग्रवाल इज नैनेक्स सर्टिफाइड सेल्स फोर्स इन सीनियर एसोसिएट लीड इन नगेरो टेक एडवाइजर एट बोधि ट्री फाउंडेशन एनजीओ. Hi, this is Praveen Goli. I am certified Salesforce administrator and working in TCS and also one of the Salesforce mentor of K University, volunteer of New Delhi Salesforce developer group. These are the initiatives taken by New Delhi Salesforce developer group. These are Twitter handles and hashtag. You can join the New Delhi Salesforce developer group. Today we have joined in new Impact Salesforce session. This is one of virtual session organized by New Delhi Salesforce Developer Group. As I said before, you can find the past and upcoming sessions in the New Delhi Salesforce Developer Group website. Talent Central is again an initiative which is taken by New Delhi Salesforce Developer Group. It is same like Naukri and Indeed. It acts as bridge in between Salesforce aspirants, students, and companies looking for talented students. Recently, New Delhi Salesforce Developer Group started new initiative, Let's Implement. Here, they connecting the mentors and mentees along with the mentorship. They will also get the hands-on experience, will be guided under the mentors. Journey to Salesforce is an initiative taken by Salesforce India Developer Relations. These are the top contributors who help in every session to organize the session, to share the details of every session on social media. These are the New Delhi Salesforce Developer Group social media handles. You can follow the channels and get updates every day. Thanks to our sponsors Cloud Vandana and GrayOps. Thank you. And over to Divya ma'am.
Thank you so much, Praveen. Guys, let me know if my screen is visible.
Yeah, it's visible.
As already you have introduced, so I'm presenting from my slide. Okay, Praveen?
Okay.
Hello, everyone. So let's say if organization can get 10 Salesforce licenses and many more services for free. Yes, through non-profit clause and Salesforce.org in all standard functionality of Lightning CRM. So means like we can use sales in a service cloud facility as well as like we are having the Lightning capability and NPSP package. The non-profit success pack is open source BSD license, means a managed package which is available on a Git, means we as a developer can contribute to that package, and even like we can find all the instruction as well over there, how we have to download, how we have to upload our changes on the nonprofit success pack. So here it is the link, like github.com Salesforce Foundation NPSP. I will show this in demo as well. Now, let's go ahead. Now, let's talk about features and benefits of nonprofit cloud. Like, nonprofit cloud empowers organizations to meet and to define their goals. Basically, they believe good cause needs good technology. So, they provide a package in which they provide the pre-configured functionalities such as program management. Let's say,
I'm sorry to interrupt. Your voice is breaking. Can you please stop the video? Hey, I am audible now, Praveen. You are audible, ma'am.
Thanks. Sorry for the internet glitch. I'm presenting again. So, Praveen, can you please clear to when you was able to hear me?
Oh, okay.
Okay. So, let's say we have completed this one, right?
Yeah.
Thank you. Now, let's go ahead and talk about nonprofit cloud. So, nonprofit cloud empowers organization, team, and define their entire mission to one integrated platform. They believe great cause deserves great technology. So, we are having so many features in a single package that is pre-configured when we have registered any Salesforce nonprofit org. Okay, so the features are to manage whole program through pre-configured program management. We can customize the program management as per our need. We are having the feature of fundraising. We are having the feature of marketing and engagement so that we can engage our donors. We can engage the people who need help, and ultimately, we can build a meaningful and enduring relationship with our constituents, who are the donors, who are the different entities in our organization. And moreover, the benefits of nonprofit cloud. So, an organization who is responsible for charity can claim for 10 enterprise edition licenses of Salesforce Sales Cloud or a Service Cloud, but $1,500. So, and even they get additional licenses on a very discounted price. Total 24% of the actual cost of the license, even lesser than that. Let's say if my license is of $150, I will get it in a $36 only. So, and they help in implementation as well. So basically, they help through the pro bono concept. Let's say there is any nonprofit organization who need to develop their solution. And as it is a nonprofit organization, so we are having the concept of pro bono, from where they can go on a salesforce.org website and then search for the pro bono partners and can take help. Like Salesforce provide staff training and events also on a discounted price. And moreover, we get the access of a power of us platform. So basically, this platform is like totally for the Salesforce nonprofit organization only, like salesforce.org. I think internet is show. Am I audible, Praveen?
No, light voice breaking.
Okay, let me switch my internet connection and I'm sorry for the glitch. I don't know why it is happening. Praveen, is it better now?
Yeah, it's better now.
Oh, thanks. Thank you for confirming. Now, we have discussed about the feature and the benefits of nonprofit organization. Now, let's go through the journey of a nonprofit organization. Basically, we all know like Salesforce Foundation started in 1999 and they come up with free and a discounted Salesforce licenses for the organizations, like nonprofit organizations. And like in 2008, Community begin work on the nonprofit starter pack, and the start of a nonprofit starter pack happened. And they come up with like. So basically, they rename as well from the starter pack to the nonprofit success pack, and they launch it like NPSP. So they did a lot of investment as well regarding to understand the nonprofit need and to provide the best solution. And like after 2 years, Salesforce.org come up with the nonprofit cloud. So like they started with the nonprofit starter pack in 2008. Then Salesforce.org in 2014, and a nonprofit success pack was there, like which we use these days as well, NPSP. And then they come up with in 2018 with a nonprofit cloud. And like in 2019, the Salesforce did the merger, and Salesforce buy Salesforce nonprofit cloud, and it comes under the Salesforce only. Then like if we take the customer feedback, so like they are having 34,000 plus customers who include for the nonprofit as well as with the education cloud. I will explain more about the same. And yes, the customer satisfaction is also very high. They believe they improve their quality and ability to achieve their mission. This is all about the journey. Nonprofit cloud. Now let's talk about products under salesforce.org. So basically salesforce.org is an umbrella in which we talk about nonprofit cloud, education, and like education cloud connect higher education as well as like KG to 12 education as well. So basically we all need in
Ma'am, your voice is again breaking.
Praveen, thanks for helping me in that. Am I audible now?
Yeah, no, it's audible.
Yeah, I don't know, even having a two internet connection, but yeah, it's breaking. Please confirm, whenever my voice is breaking, please confirm. I will try to switch internet or something else.
Okay.
Thanks. So basically, through the non-profit cloud, we are helping the charitable organization. Our main purpose to increase the operational effectiveness of the non-profit organization. Then in our higher education, we provide driver and institute success from anywhere through the education cloud. So basically, COVID teach lot of things to us. And now we know education institute get in need agile platform to meet and involve in lead of the entire company. So basically they should move their platform on agile so that they can manage their all the volunteers very well and for the education purpose as well, their whole staff. And they can maintain it in an agile process to for the better impact. We can get help from the education cloud through the for the KG to 12 as well, school education. So connect teams to better support student and with education club for consider of us is to increase the volunteership and empower the employees. So now let's have a demo. So basically, like I mentioned earlier as well, we are having this GitHub URL as well. So where I can see all the push and pull on the non-profit success path. I can go on instruction side as well, what I need to follow to push our changes on the non-profit, if I am having any suggestion. So basically what I have done for this session, I registered 30-day free trial auth. It is same as we register for the developer auth. So same form we need to fill. But the URL is different. From there, we can fill the form. And then, yes, we are having this 30-day free trial org. So having all the capabilities that any nonprofit organization, nonprofit cloud have. So basically, when we log in onto this org, we are having access of this we are having some information as so we are having the tutorials of that as well, and we can explore more on the trailhead as well. Now let's in a cloud or a service cloud, we are having a create one contact. Let's name it Praveen. Basically, only the last name is needed, it is optional as well. Only the last name is needed. So basically, I am filling my donor information over here or a volunteer information over here, and I am saving it. When I save my contact, then household get created. So household is head of the family who presented my whole family. So from this, we are having a 360 view of our customers, client, donor, whatever you would like to say. So basically, we get all the information, first gift date, last gift date, and what was the amount. And the total amount, household, if we talk about, when we talk about household, so there can be multiple contexts. Let's say Praveen Guli is the head of the family, and then their relatives can have their contact under this account, and we can have a 360 view of his profile, of his like what the contribution is done by his or his family. So basically we can recalculate the roll-ups as well. Let's say like if we see checking and we are not finding the data in a correct manner. So yeah, and now let's go to the to this contact. So basically like we are managing the account, then we are on the contact, we are managing further information. So let's say like we are having different kind of donations, like donation or a gift or a, like any major gift or any other thing. So let's say like if I'm making a new in-kind gift, so basically it's like I select the type, whether it's a good or whether he's providing some services, helping through some services. So let's say like I select services. I can enter the market value. Let's say it's $1,000 value. So I can attach it with the particular campaign. And the most beneficial part, like we can manage the stage as well as we can acknowledge the donor or the constituent. Like whether, like thanks for donating, thanks for connecting with us. And here we can manage the status, like to be acknowledged, like yet to be acknowledged, or already acknowledged, or do not acknowledge this person, just email that person because of any blockage or something. And from stages as well, like we can manage whether it's a prospecting or not yet received or like withdrawn from him. So or more time, like it's a, like I just register 30-day free trial org, and after this whole I get it. I have not configured anything yet on it. Am I audible?
Yeah, it's audible.
Thanks. So basically, like when I create any new donation, so it's opportunity get created. So it's an opportunity that is like over here, I can have all such details and yes, on the top, the path as well, and all the contact details and such thing in the opportunity form. And here, like you can see the opportunity name or the like household name, this like goalie, like a last name followed by selecting the services. The fields are different over here as per the donation type. And here we can manage the relationship as well. Let's say like if I'm managing any new relation with the Praveen Goli, I can manage, like I can select any contact, and then I can select the type, like whether it's a friend, co-worker, or anything. Like we can manage, like from this here you can see like they try to provide a whole umbrella, like whole all the features that might non-profit need help with. So and on top of it is all configurable. And now let's talk about, this is the flow, first flow, very first flow. Then we are having the recurring donations as well. Let's say we want to manage a recurring donation, like any organization or a particular contact give the recurring donation. Let's say like if I'm filling he donate $100,000 per month, it is depend on me how I want, like on which day of the month, like payment method I can select, and recurring and the effective date from where when I need to start, whether it is part of any campaign, I can save it. And then also like I get a very good view of whole recurring donations activities. Like I can see my active schedules, I can see like upcoming installation, I can see all the details over here as well, what he have contributed so far. And then I can close this recurring donation as well. So let's say like I am adding like the reason, and then I'm saving it, then all the active schedule and upcoming installation would be like yes, there is no further installation. So it's like on click, I am able to manage my things in a very good way. And if I see, I will come up in on my contact again. I can see like yes, about the recurring donations part as well, because it is related to the same contact. Then, as I was talking about, like we are having all such thing in a configurable form. So basically, like we are having NPSP settings. It is one of the tab that is available with this package, and from here, like we can manage all such configure all such thing. Let's say like we were talking about household name, right? So it automatically get created by last name followed by household. So yes. Like from the nonprofit success pack settings, from the people tab, I can have this detail. Like I can manage my further things. I can manage like what should be the first name of my household and all such information. So it is like for the household, but yes, for other things as well. Like for the relationship, I can maintain, I can configure my things. For the donation part, I can configure my part. And then for the recurring donation as well, I can configure the settings and for all such things. So this is like through this, we can configure through the administrator. And on top of it, yes, we can write the code as well. We are having the DAP console, right? We can write any trigger, any flows that we want on top of it. So basically, it's a fully customized platform that we can do further. So, and there's a one more benefit that comes along with this cost, that is a power of us hub. Basically, the power of us hub is like something here I have opened, like it's a three-step process for the one time. Here, I agree with the terms and conditions. I've already opened over here. Let's see. So basically, like firstly we agree, and there we select our role, like whether we are from KG to 12 roles or a higher education or from nonprofit cloud. So let's say like I am selecting one. I am selecting like in what are my interests, and so like my post. Praveen, am I audible?
It's not audible.
Thanks. So basically, it's a power of us community. Over here, we can find posts and queries, and we can answer as well. So basically, here, as per the Salesforce, like there are 50,000 plus developers who are currently connected on this Power of Us hub. And let's say like we can ask our general query. Let's say I'm not able to implement something or I'm facing any issue. So I can search it over. I can post my query over here. And within 24 hours, as per the Salesforce, like we get the reply. And sometimes we as a developer think it's a silly question, but when we post it and then we found it's a similar question for others as well. So we get our reply because all are working on the same scenario in a very fast manner. So this is for the nonprofit purpose, for the Salesforce.org only. Like Salesforce.org, like for the education, philanthropy, and for the nonprofit cloud only. And we are having very cool salesforce.org website as well. From here, like we can have all the details, like what they provide, what are the eligibility criteria, like what are these systems, what all the partners who are using nonprofit cloud and all such information blocks, lot of things we can find over here. Now, so anybody is having any query? Anybody is having any query? Okay, so we will take the query in the last of the session as well. Now let's go ahead with the session. So now let's talk about, like, we talk about Salesforce, the nonprofit, to how it looks like how the org looks like and how it is different from a sales and a service cloud. So basically, yes, like, we are having similar objects, but it is a pre-configured as per the organization need, as per the nonprofit organization need. So if we talk about the people in nonprofit, we talk about, like, executive director. So basically, he is the key person, he or she will be the key person of the organization who is managing all such thing, and basically who is responsible for taking the decisions as well. So, and after that, the people come out like development director or a finance director or a program manager. And yes, of course, Salesforce admin, who will configure the org, because it's like a common org for all, but all the organizations is having the different needs. So basically, the Salesforce admin can help to make it better. I can see one. And then we talk about the donors, board of directors. So board of directors directly connect with the executive director for the further decisions and for all such things. And then we are having the program constituents, volunteer who are collaborated or associated with the nonprofit organization, trying to help people by giving the goods or services, or by making the funds, by helping through CSR activity and lot more. So now let's talk about NPS features and a nonprofit cloud application. So we are having like different kind of opportunities over here, or income sources, you can see. So basically, like, if you know about Salesforce, so all such things like grants, major gifts are available as an opportunity record type. So these all kind of opportunities we can manage on a separate way. So basically, we are having the grants. Grants is nothing like funds we get from the any other organization or entity. Major gifts, we talk about the donation, a small donation or a big donation or a recurring donation. We talk about in-kind gifts, whether in form of good or services. We get help from government as well, like a nonprofit organization get help from government as well, like from the central or a federal or a state government. We get the help. So basically, they provide the fund for the particular cause. Then let's say, like, if I am organizing any program or I am running any campaign, so I want to manage the income from that particular program, so that also I can manage in a proper way. Then we talk about the corporate. We know, like, in our corporate, we are having the CSR role. CSR activities are there. So from that as well, people can earn, the nonprofit can get the benefit from through the CSR, as the company have to do the CSR. Now, let's talk about the donation entities. So basically, the donation entities are like, we manage the donations. So I can say one question as well from Jagti, how to work for nonprofit in India and how many are using nonprofit with respect to India? So basically, it depends how you want to work for nonprofit, whether you want it is already established organization, and we will take this question in the last of the session in details. Thanks, Jagdeep, for your question. So basically, because like some of your question will be answered through this session, so that's why I will try to answer it in the last. And now let's talk about the donation entry. So we talk about the payments that we receive or that we do. Then we talk about the recurring donations. Then we talk about the GAU. So basically, the GAU is like general accounting unit. So these are like, we segregate our funds for the particular purpose. Let's say like if it is a like we are providing the education, so we are we keep our funds for buying the like books and copies only. So we are keeping our funds for the particular purpose. So that is comes under GAU. Now let's talk about the soft credit. So soft credit is nothing like we are having the benefit, like some organization do like this. Let's say if their worker contributed $50, so they will contribute $50 from their side as well. So the total contribution to the organization would be $100. So we will maintain all this information in the in our org through this way. So it's like pre-configured, we can use the pre-configured thing. Then we are highly encouraged to manage our donor activities as well. So let's say if somebody have contributed for us, so like we always try to acknowledge by email, by SMSing, and by other details, and we manage the address of our donor. We manage the naming convention, like I showed you as well. We manage their mailing list, as there can be a multiple members from the family who are contributing for the nonprofit. So we maintain the relationship from the system perspective as well, and moreover as well. So we are having a volunteer for Salesforce as well. So basically, like, it is also another package that we can install in our org. So it is for like we are managing our volunteers. Let's say we are managing their time block. So we manage basically our volunteers so that we can help them as well and take help in a proper way. So let's say like if they want any query, so they can post it over there. So it's like we can connect our nonprofit org with the volunteer for Salesforce package as well. Then the nonprofit organization, yes, they take the wooden services from other or donation, but sometimes they also do from their side as well. So that is come as under outbound gifts, outbound funds, grant making. So now organization, let's say, is giving to others. So it is a new feature, and yes, we manage this as well. And we already talked about the Power of Us Hub, which is a dedicated community for Salesforce.org purpose. And we get our solution in a very fast way. And the other major parts like NPSP settings, we talk about the same. And we can manage the bulk processes as well, like bulk import. We can check our health of the NPSP organization as well, like how we are going. Are we hitting our mission or not? Are we on the right track or not? That also we can check through the NPSP health check. Yes, then we can use like Salesforce major features like report and dashboard. We can generate the report and dashboard on the basis of our need, like on for the particular for the particular context, for the particular set of context, or like for the particular kind of opportunities we can track. So I saw one question. So let's say like if we are talking about like how we can help nonprofit organization. So basically, let's say like we want to do the newly development. Let's say like there is an organization like Udaan, and they might not use any software, let's say. And I want to suggest to use Salesforce.org, because they not need to pay as well. And I am as a developer ready to contribute for them, right? So like it comes under new implementation. What you need to do, you need to register first 30-day free trial org. And on top of it, like you start configuring your organization need. So basically, like you can help the organization in cleaning the data. Let's say like the organization managing the data on the Excel sheets. So we can help in maintaining and in their cleaning the data. We can import their data into the system onto the org. We can do the configuration as per the organization need. We can do further integration as well. Like, let's say, like, we want to do something like the payment or integrate with the payment system. That also we can do. And now, let's say, like, any nonprofit organization is already using a nonprofit cloud or Salesforce platform. Let's say, like, we talk about a Smile Foundation. They are already taking, let's say, Salesforce. So we can help in different other ways. Let's say, like, if they configured in an initial phase, so we can help in upgrading their nonprofit success pack to the household model that I have showed you. And then we help can help them in implementing the new tools and new feature in their org. We can donate our time by coding for them. So I get to know, like, there are so many, you can find on Upwork as well, not even of India, all over the world, organization post their need over there. Like, we want a developer for our community, right? So maybe, like, they can give you some stipend as well. So yes, from there as well, you can contribute to the society. I can see one more comment. Thanks, Tisha. So, thank you, Jagdeep, for asking the question. And then we are having the deduping as well. So, deduping, like, we are try to shorten their process. Like, let's say, like, if they follow 10 steps for the particular work, you know, from the Salesforce or from through the digital world, we can shorter these steps. Even like if it is taking long time, we can make it like in a few minutes only. Then yes, we can help them in NPSP configurations as well. So apart from this, like let's say, like, if we talk about the free licenses, we get 10 free sales or service cloud licenses. But let's say, like, if they want to enhance their system, so through the public side we can help, or we can help through the through the public side, we can help them, or we can ask to buy some community licenses. And again, the community licenses also would be on a very discounted price, so we can cater help more and more people. And then we can suggest marketing cloud as well to the nonprofit organization to reach to the mass. Now, let's talk about installing NPSP. We are having three options to install NPSP, and we will talk about the pros and cons as well. So basically, like, let's say, like, I did one 30-day free trial of NPSP org. The pros are, it is like the similar forms we are having in for the developer org, like similar forms I need to fill. Then there is, like, I get the essence of a power of a hub. It is like pre-configured. Whole org is pre-configured. Then we can submit our nonprofit application to keep it. Let's say I have registered for a 30-day free trial, and it I'm on the 25th day. I'm still configuring. I'm still trying to sort out all my developers who would be there into the system and all the key entities. So I can raise a ticket on Salesforce support, and I can extend my time period from 30 days. Or the cons is, like, yeah, it expired in a 30 days. And we can install. So NPSP is available as a managed package as well on an app exchange. So in for the DevOps, we can, voice is breaking. Hi, Praveen, am I audible? Hi, Pranchal, is it clear now?
Yeah, it's clear now.
Okay, perfect. Thanks for confirming. Good to go. Thanks, Murugam. Thank you. So basically, we are talking about now how we can install it. The nonprofit application to keep it neat. I'm using nonprofit organize X, like I registered a 30-day free trial org, right? And I want to further keep it. Let's say I'm in process of managing. So I will talk about like eligibility criteria for the free licenses as well, right? So basically, I'm in the process of finalizing all such things for all such approval. So I can write a ticket on a Salesforce support to extend my duration. So that it would not be expire in 30 days. Otherwise, after if you log in on the 31st day, you will find your org is not available, right? At that time also, you can write to the Salesforce support team, like you are just managing it, right? So that's how we are managing, like submit nonprofit application to keep my org active. Now let's talk about install from Trailhead. Yes, we can install from Trailhead as well this package, and it will never expire. In our dev org as well, we can install from the Trailhead. So we will get hands-on experience of configuring the NPSP as well. Basically, like in current org, all such things are pre-configured. But when I am installed it from the Trailhead, so there are a lot of things that I need to do from my side. So I will get good hands-on as well. And the only drawback would be like there would be no access of a Power of Us hub. You will not be able to access the Power of Us hub from if you like install a nonprofit package on your dev org or like you are installing it from the Trailhead. Now let's talk about the eligibility criteria for free licenses. So basically, your primary purpose is charitable. Let's say if you are a charitable organization, so why to buy licenses? Yes, we can get it for free as well. Yes, and we understand this as well, like the nonprofit organization already running out of funds. So instead of paying to Salesforce, they can take help from the Salesforce and even for the add-on licenses as well. Or your purpose of the organization should be education, whether it's a primary, secondary, or a higher education you are providing. So basically, you are talking about primary, secondary, or a higher education. So basically, any government institute or any institute who are providing the education for free can get benefit of education cloud free licenses. Otherwise, other education institute also can register, but they have to pay. Not more, but yes, they have to pay. So they help in like other scenarios as well, like environmental, humanitarian, or like any sport body, or like the primary purpose, like social benefiting, like when we were talking about a philanthropy cloud. So yes, like if I am doing any social welfare or I'm doing anything for the social interest, so yes, then also like I can apply for the free licenses. Now, what need to do for the free licenses, what application we will require to submit, like Jagdeep asked, let's say if we want to contribute to any organization who is not using Salesforce or we want to help with the Salesforce platform, so first like we will register for a 30-day free trial, so we should have an active trial org. So that's why I talk about keeping my 30-day free trial on so that I can further apply for the free licenses as well. I need to submit, we are getting 10 free licenses. So I need to submit system administrator name and their emails, like who all 10 will be my system administrator. So I need to provide their name as well as their email ID. Then I need to submit the executive approval as well, who is going to run the show, who will be responsible for the whole org, for all such calls. Then we talk about the tax ID. Yes, we need to submit a tax ID as well for this application. Then we need to do like your submit the ethics certification and approval from a main central office. It is for the education only, like for nonprofit, we not need to submit this ethics certification, but for the education cloud, we need to submit this as well. And let's say, like, if I belongs to US Canada region, so I need to submit 501c3 letter. Or if I belongs to any other region, like Singapore, India, Europe, so I just need to submit the legal documentation that should be approved by central government. So that's it from my side. You can follow me on Twitter, LinkedIn, Trailhead. Like I'm having the common handler, Tech Diva Divya. So you can find me on LinkedIn. Let's connect. Now let's have a, and this is, if anybody is having any queries, let's talk. Let's say, like, nobody is asking, so let me ask Jagdeep. So what was your how you would like to help to the non-profit organization? Can you please explain, Jagdeep? I cannot hear any sound. Am I audible? I can see one message. So basically, thanks. So I have few queries in chat. Let me read one by one. Okay, I can see now. As a developer, I can see, like, Bhagwat question. As a developer, can I help to any nonprofit organization? Yes, as a developer, you can, as I am connected with the nonprofit global community as well, then I get to know, like, on a Upwork as well, you can register yourself, you can see the post of the people. They are the organization from all of the world. All over the world, post, yeah. Hello, am I audible right now?
Yeah, now it's audible.
Thanks. Yeah. So basically, we can get the leads from there, or we can connect with any nonprofit organization. We can connect with any nonprofit organization and then take their needs and then can help in system in place. Where can we register for helping nonprofit? Is there any website? So, Jagdeep, there is no particular website, but I heard about, like, people take, even like people who are in UK take help from the Upwork. Like, from Upwork, they get the leads. So, like, who are already using nonprofit organization and now they want to help. And I think there is a other way as well. Register for a 30-day free trial. You will get the access of power of us community. And from there, you can connect with the people who need help, or you can try to solve their problems over there. Might be they will onboard you, and you can definitely show this your experience in your resume, and you can say like, yes, I come and I help such organization. So by this, like, you can help non-profit organization as a admin. And like, I can see one more question as well. Is Salesforce giving free license to higher education KG to 12 also? So basically, yes, Salesforce give free license for the higher education as well as KG to 12. But the institute should provide the education for free. That is the first way. And the other is like, or it is a government institute. For these two purposes, for these two kind of organization, you get the free licenses. Otherwise, yes, you have to pay for the education purpose. If someone from India, should I have to go with our work or any other thing else? Anything else? If someone from India. So I believe, Bhagwat, please try to register for a 30-day free trial. And then, yes, over there, like, you can, maybe like, you can register parallelly on our work. And from the power of us, how as well you may get the lead. And yeah, you can connect with me on LinkedIn and we can talk further about the same. Is there any other query, guys? Praveen can answer better. Is there any voucher available for this session? Praveen, I think we are having the quiz.
Yeah, I'm sharing the screen.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much, Praveen. And I would like to thank to Shushant as well to connect with me and to have me over here. All the best, guys. Thank you, Panchal. I can see so many participants. It's interesting. Wow, I can see so many participants.
Now starting the quiz.
congratulations, Tejasvi. Congratulations, Lakshmi. Congratulations, Path.
Winners can share their mail ID and LinkedIn credentials in chat box.
So, how many vouchers are there, Praveen? Am I audible? I can see the details of the banner.
हेलो,